I take this piece of paper and fold it in half, its thickness is now double what it was. It's two times thicker. If I fold this paper in half again, it's now four times thicker. And if I fold it in half a third time, it's eight times thicker than the original piece of paper. So what happens when we keep doing this? Well, let's find out. I got to about seven folds before I just couldn't fold it anymore. At seven folds, it's 128 times thicker than it originally was, which is about 12 millimeters. Now, your normal piece of paper can't be folded more than eight times because it's just not big enough. But what if we had an even bigger piece of paper? Could we keep folding it more than seven times? And what if this sheet was big enough to fold our piece of paper, say, 30 times over? What would that look like? If we take a normal piece of paper, which is about 0.1 millimeters thin, and fold it in half 30 times, its height will actually be higher than our atmosphere, over 100 kilometers. Okay, that's crazy, but let's keep going. At 50 folds, it's to the sun, 93 million miles. And if we could possibly fold a piece of paper 103 times, it will be bigger than the known universe. 93 billion light years long. Now obviously there's no such paper big enough to be folded that many times, but let's try something else. Take your piece of paper and cut it in half instead of folding it. What you now have is half of what you originally had. But if we cut it in half again, what will we have? 1/4. After seven cuts, it's the length of an ant. At 11 cuts, it's as thin as it is thick, so about 0.1 millimeters. And at 31 cuts, it's the size of an atom. You should probably stop cutting here because you don't want to split an atom in half. I promise you that. This whole thing is a fun experiment in the power of X. The mathematics behind both of these is exactly the same, just in opposite directions. Folding the piece of paper increases the thickness by 2 to the power of the number of folds, so 2 to the x, where x is how many times you've folded it. So at 1 fold, it's 2 times thicker. At 3 folds, it's 8 times thicker. Now cutting it in half is the exact same thing, just in the opposite direction on the x-axis. So that would be this way for you guys, because it's this way for me and it's opposite of what I'm saying. Yes. Now we can look at a simple exponential graph that shows just how fast 2 to the power of x increases. That means if you fold a piece of paper in half 20 times, you're over 1 million times thicker than what you started with. Thanks for watching this video, and if you liked it, please thumbs up and drop a comment. Don't forget to subscribe to see all my future videos, and I'll see you guys next week.